A man sits alone in his rich apartment in New York City. He's morose, lost. His wife has left him. If you were a friend of his, you'd go and spend some time with him. Have a few drinks. Listen to some music. Try to cheer him up. Some of his friends did. It started a night of terror. Hello, creeps. This is T4Y, opening the doors of the Mystery Playhouse. Our story tonight is from the pen of the master mystery writer, William Irish. The author needs no introduction. All of you dyed-in-the-wool mystery fans are familiar with hard-writing, fast-moving William Irish tales. Our story begins in the lobby of a New York apartment building. Two men and a woman have just entered. They're raucous and cheerful, obviously out for a night of fun.
Hey, that's a nice apartment building,
oh,
huh?
The fella Turner must have a lot of cash to live in a place like this, huh, Jack?
Oh, he has more than most, I guess. Here's the elevator, Vinny.
Hey, self-service! Let me push the button. First floor, ladies' garments, summer dresses, lingerie.
I'll take lingerie.
Vinny, when you get there, take it easy, huh? Like I told you, this Turner's a nice guy.
Well, what's he like, Jack, this joker we're doing a good turn for?
Oh, he's a good-natured character. Right now, the big thing is his wife, Eleanor, leaving him. I haven't seen him smile since she pulled out on him. And Marty.
Yeah?
Look, remember, don't make any cracks about his wife, Eleanor, or any bonus, will you?
I got you.
I hope he's home. Oh, hello, Guy.
Hello, Jack.
Eleanor.
Hiya, Guy. Meet Vinnie Benson.
Oh, it's dark in the hall. I thought you were my wife.
Oh, that's okay.
I hope we're not disturbing you, Guy.
Oh, no. Come in. Please, all of you.
Oh, thanks.
Go ahead, Vinny.
Say, sure is a nice apartment. Shows good taste.
Oh, sit down. I'll fix you a drink.
Oh, Guy, you don't have to. We only
want... No, I'd like to, honestly. What'll it be? There's some whiskey, I think. And still have some of that good brandy that Eleanor liked so much. What'll it be, Jack?
Okay. Whiskey, Guy, and plain water.
I've always been kind of hot for brandy.
Sure. Marty?
Well, I think I'll try the brandy, too, if you don't mind.
Not at all.
Guy, we thought maybe you'd like to go out with us and hear some music later.
Well, I don't know. I kind of figured I'd staying home tonight, Jack.
Hey, you mind if I get something on the radio?
Not at all. Go ahead.
You're sure this is all right, Guy? I mean, we're not disturbing you, are
you? Sure, Jack. I'd tell you if it were. Well, come on, drink up. Hey, you don't want to stop, do you, Vinny?
Oh, yeah. You're wearing me out.
Oh, but it's fun. I'm just getting going.
Hey, one of these days, your heart's going to say the heck with all this and blank out on you.
Well, that's what happens when I drink whiskey. I can't help it. I get going and I can't stop.
Hey, why don't you try a shot of this? It'll slow you down.
Oh, well, what is it?
Oh, never mind that. Just try it. It's kind of liqueur.
All right, now, just a minute. Maybe you better not, Marty. He's had enough.
Go on, Guy. Take it. You only live once. Just slow you down. That's all.
Well, okay, if that's all it says. Hey, where'd Vinny go? I want to dance.
Oh, look what I found.
Well, Vinny, what is it?
Well, look, it's a picture of Guy's wife. Huh? Two Guy with more than love, now and forever, Eleanor. Guy says I look like her. I don't think she's so hot myself.
What are you doing? Put that down.
All right, don't get sore.
Don't touch it again, please.
Look. Why don't we all make tracks downtown? Maybe we can still catch some music,
huh? It's kind of late for that, ain't it?
Hey, I know where we can go, Jack.
You mean West 65th?
Yeah.
Will they let us in?
Sure. They know me there. Come on, let's go, huh?
Hey,
kind of crowded tonight, ain't you, Al?
Well, you won't be lonely.
You're wearing a gun, hey, Al?
Well, maybe if the cop was a little more friendly, I wouldn't have to.
Oh, the latest model, too, a .32 caliber. Bang, you're dead. Hey, Mr. Dan. Oh, come on, I don't bite.
You mean you, Guy?
Uh-oh. Okay, sure. Don't go away, Jack, Minnie. I won't be long.
Okay. Marty.
Eh?
Look, don't give him any more to drink. I don't like the way he...
Come off
it. Oh, the little father.
No, now listen, kid. He's in bad shape.
Oh, he's in bad shape. It's his funeral.
I'm hungry.
Well, the kitchen's out this way. Hey, Jack.
Yeah?
Why don't you get the drinks while I fix the meats, huh?
Okay.
Marty, where'd you go? I've been looking for you for hours.
Oh, I've been making some sandwiches. Here, have...
No.
Go ahead, have
No, them. No, thanks. Why'd you go away and leave me so long? Hey, they're playing that song again. That's our song. It belongs to Eleanor and me. I told them what I'd do if they played it again. I told them not to play it again.
Hey, boys, where's Jack?
Eleanor. Hello, what are you doing here?
Eleanor? Marty, is he high? Pal, don't you remember me?
Eleanor, what are you doing in a place like this?
Same thing as you are, handsome, and don't call me Eleanor.
You've changed. You never used to be like this, Eleanor. Do you come here often?
Oh, only when the going gets slow. Oh, hey, there's Jack. Hey, Jack, let's make like the South America.
Eleanor, come back. Eleanor, come back here. Marty, Eleanor ran away from me. Why is she running away like that? Oh, help me catch her, Marty.
Hey, come on. Just let me finish making a sandwich.
No, Marty, please.
All right, okay, I'm done. Yeah. Maybe you better take this along. Sure, you mean business, you know?
Oh, what is it?
Just a kitchen knife. Sure, you're not kidding.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, come on.
You start looking. I'll be right with you.
Eleanor. Hello, where'd you go? Please come back. Excuse me, have you seen Eleanor?
Hey, watch it, buddy. You're messing up traffic.
I'm looking for Eleanor, my wife. She was here just a... Oh, there she is. Eleanor.
Hiya,
Hans. Eleanor, they're playing our song. We've got to get away from here. We don't belong
oh,
here,
but
Eleanor.
I like it.
I said we're leaving.
Oh, here's Jack. I want to dance with Jack.
You're leaving with me.
Hey, Guy, give me that knife.
What's cooking, kid?
Marty, Guy's out of his head.
Oh, come off it, Jack. It's good for a while.
Oh, come on, Jack. Let's dance.
No, Eleanor, not to our song.
That's why I want to dance to
No, you're not going to.
Get your hands off me. Let's
No.
Oh, you stabbed her.
Eleanor.
Why'd you do it? Marty, Jack, help. Help.
Blood. You stabbed her, Guy. It's blood.
She's not my wife. She's not Eleanor.
A heart stop. Hey, Jack, help me get her to a car.
I didn't mean it. Let me out of here.
Al, stop him. Stop him, Al. Come on, Marty. We got to get him.
You get him.
Al, why didn't you stop him?
Stop him? Hey, he snatched my gun out of my holster, and I'm supposed to stop him? Mister, I want to live a while yet.
Well, I'd better get after him. I'd better get the police after him.
Do you have a telephone here?
In the back.
Commonwealth. Mrs. Guy Turner, quickly, please.
We have no one here by that name.
Eleanor Turner, I'm positive she's registered there.
I'm sorry, we have no one here by that name.
Oh, try it under Eleanor Phillips, I'm sure she's there.
It's Phillips, room 304, I'll ring it for you. There doesn't seem to be any answer.
Keep ringing, she's got to be in.
Yes, sir.
Answer it, Eleanor, please. Please answer it, Eleanor. Eleanor, cops just came in the store. What should I do, Eleanor? You have to come up here to me. He's coming back this way. I've never used a gun before. What should I do? He's coming to get me. Put his hand in his pocket. He's reaching for a gun. No!
Take it easy, Sonny. You'll
You killed him.
He was reaching for his gun.
But you only wanted to call his wife. His wife is sick. He calls her every night.
He was reaching for his gun.
He was only getting a nickel for the phone.
I gotta get out of here. I gotta get out of here.
The police. I must call the police. Hello. Operator. Operator.
Please deposit 5 cents for the next 5 minutes. Your time is up.
Look, lady, I'm from headquarters. Now, just give it to me slow and easy now. How was this guy dressed, lady?
Was he blonde with a gray shirt?
Yes, and he was rumpled and...
Did he have on a black tie?
Yes, a black tie.
Does that sound like the guy that was at the party with you?
Yeah, that's him, all right. No, if only we could have hit him off.
Too late now, brother.
Good night, Matt. I had a wonderful time. Call me when you get home, and I'll let you know about tomorrow. Night.
Eleanor.
What? Hello, Guy.
What's the matter with the light over here?
What's the trouble, Guy? You look so scared.
Nothing. I mean, I have to talk to you. I kept calling you, but...
Of course, Guy. Come on up for a few minutes.
No, I can't go next to my thing. Is there a back entrance?
Oh, God. Looks like you need some black coffee again. Down this alley over here, there's a back entrance and a service elevator. Down here, Guy.
Yes. You think anyone saw it?
What are you afraid of this time, Guy? I'm here. I won't leave you.
Someone will be following.
How should anyone be following you? Besides, the alley's empty. No one uses it at this hour. Here. Take my hand. Guy. What are you doing with a gun? It's all right, Guy. We're safe in here.
You sure?
I live here, Guy.
Let me look in the closet.
Look under the bed, too, if it'll help you any. Sit down, Guy. I've never seen you so upset. Relax for a minute.
Where are you going?
Just to put my coat away.
Take it off in here.
Of course, Guy. Now, what is it?
Can I trust you not to give me away?
Guy, after all these years...
But I'll be at your mercy after I told you I'll be wide open.
Then maybe you'd better not come.
No, I've got to.
All right. Tell me then, Guy. You can trust me. You know that.
Eleanor, I killed a girl over in the place where I was.
Are you sure, Guy?
I saw them pick her up. They said so. I saw the blood. I had the knife in my hand. I didn't mean to. Well, why didn't you say something?
I guess I wasn't counting on anything like that. Pretty bad, Guy, but the only thing to do is to go back. You didn't know.
You don't understand. There was a second one.
Guy.
A policeman in a candy store. He came in and I did that one on purpose.
Guy, what's the trouble with you? It's not whiskey, I don't think, but you don't think...
They said it was some kind of liquor. It slows everything down.
Oh. Yeah.
Yeah.
Guy, don't pace the floor like that. Sit down and rest.
Who is the man in the cab with you?
A friend.
He'll be coming back. He'll be coming up here.
No, he won't. Don't you want to lie down for a while, Guy? You seem tired. It'll help wear it off.
What are you reaching for? What are you doing? I saw your hand go out.
I just wanted a cigarette, Guy. Here they are, right down here. See them?
You're standing near the door and you were a moment ago.
Sit all the way over here. I won't move, I promise. Don't, Guy. Don't look at me like that.
You're afraid of me. You're afraid of me because...
I don't have any choice the way you're acting. Please, Guy. Lie down for a few minutes. Try closing your eyes for just a minute and resting. Give me a chance.
Give me a chance to go down to the lobby.
I won't move. I'll sit beside you. And you can hold my hand. I'll tie my wrist to yours.
Who is it?
I won't know, Guy, until I answer.
Don't touch it. Keep your hand still. I saw it move.
Probably Matt. The man you saw bring me home. He knows I'm here. If I don't answer it, Guy, he'll know something's wrong. It'll be worse than if I do. I won't say anything, Guy. I'll tell him I'm in bed. I'll ask him not to bother me.
Yeah, go ahead. Get rid of him.
Hello? Hello? Please, hello. He hung up.
What are you crying for?
Please, Guy. Please, this is useless. Let's figure out something. Please don't look at me like that!
I'm hungry.
I can have some sandwiches sent up from the drugstore. They toast them. They put lots of mayonnaise on them. I'll call them.
I haven't eaten for 2 days. I haven't eaten since Tuesday, since before I went to that place. How do I know you won't get me away?
You'll hear me. You'll be right here beside me while I call.
What about when he comes up?
I'll have him leave it at the door outside, on the floor. I won't let him in.
I'm hungry.
Don't hold the pen at my cheek like that. I can't talk.
Drugstore, good evening.
This is Miss Phillips. Will you send up 2 sandwiches, please? Double-deckers. Toasted with lots of mayonnaise and coffee in a container, just like the other night.
Oh, what's the matter, Miss Phillips? Can't you get to sleep again? You want some of that sleeping stuff again?
A lot. A lot of mayonnaise. Thank you.
How do I know who you were talking to?
But you heard me.
How long will it take to get up here?
About 5 minutes.
Yeah, we'll see. If it doesn't show up in 5 minutes, I know you put something over on me.
You can't figure time anymore. You said Tuesday was 2 nights ago. It's still only Tuesday night. You won't be able to tell, Guy.
You seem frightened. You just phoned for sandwiches. Why are you looking so white and frightened?
Let me call him back and tell him to hurry.
Don't touch that phone. I was a fool to let you the first time.
Look at the clock. It's 4:25. What's the clock, for heaven's sake, Guy? Let me have a cigarette, please. Pass me one yourself if you won't let me.
Here. Light it yourself.
I will. Your pacing doesn't help any.
It's taking a long time. It's taking more than 5 minutes.
Coffee maker may be out of order. May have gotten off at the wrong floor. Any little thing might have.
You didn't phone for room service. You dialed the police. They're probably on their way right here now.
You heard me.
I can't remember what I heard anymore. I can't think straight. You know it. You're trying to take advantage of me. You're just trying to kid me along. I know how they close in on someone they're after. They sneak up and surround the place first. That's what's taking them so long. It's over 30 minutes already.
It isn't. It's only 4 minutes. Look at the clock.
You set it back when I wasn't looking. It was a long time ago you called down.
Our song... I have it here. Let me play it, please.
Hey, you're just stalling.
Remember that first Christmas in New Hampshire, the tree we put up? Those long hikes we took in the snow? Remember how we left this record on for hours? It's only 6 minutes, Guy. Guy, put the gun away. Don't look like that, Guy. It's our song.
Why did you have to give me away? I only wanted to hide out here until they forgot about me. Why'd you have to phone and tell them where they could find me?
I didn't phone the police, Guy. I only want to be left in peace. I only want to be married and left in peace. Let me marry Matt, please.
Now, I'm sure you told him.
Only 6.5 minutes. Not fair.
Helen and Donna, I didn't mean it. Don't die, please. I was mixed up. I thought... Eleanor. Eleanor.
How's that for quick service, Miss Phillips? Mayonnaise and all.
Oh. Miss Phillips. Get in here. Get in all the way.
What? Sure. Yeah, I know a gun when I see one. Okay, I'm in. Where to?
I don't know. That closet over there.
Okay, I'm going. Just quit shaking like that. You'll set that gun off by mistake.
Who is it?
You always open the door.
No.
Miss Phillips, open the door. This is the police.
Please, they're after me.
Miss Phillips, wipe off.
You, back entrance.
Not here, there isn't.
The window.
Sure, it's only 14 stories of the street.
You're lying.
So I'm lying.
Get out of the way.
It's your funeral, mister.
There's a ledge.
Sure, you got a good 6 inches, maybe 6 and a half.
Don't come near me.
You're crazy, Turner. You'll be killed if you go out there.
I'm going.
He ain't kidding.
Don't be a fool, Turner.
The way he is, he'll never keep us balanced.
Turner! Now look, I have no gun. Come back in and we'll talk it over. We'll make a deal.
Leave me alone.
Okay, Turner, I'm coming out after you.
What are you trying to be, a sucker or a hero?
Come on, Turner, the party's over.
It's your life.
Now give me a hand. I'll help you back in.
Don't come any closer.
Now, look, be sensible, will you? 14 stories down. Now, let's get in off this ledge before we both fall. Now, here. Give me a hand.
I'm telling you, don't touch me. Let go.
Turner, you fool, don't fight me. You'll knock us both off.
Now, let go.
Turner, stop it.
Turner, look out.
Vinny. Oh, Mamie. Hello. How are you, dearie? Oh, I was out in the party with Jack and Marty. Yeah. And then Marty and I pull a swell joke on a guy. We laugh. I thought I'd die. Well, this guy Turner was high as a kite, see? And Marty gave him a knife, and this Turner makes a grab at me. So I make like I'm stabbed and squeeze ketchup between my fingers. Oh, he was so scared he just ran right out. Sure, the next time I see him, I'm going to tell him about the ketchup. Boy, I'll bet he'll laugh his head off.
That was one of the new William Irish stories heard on your Mystery Playhouse. One of the best mysteries T4Y's heard in many a moon. Now we have some news for you. First, we've gotten a wire from Peter Lorre, mine host. He broke the lease on the cage he was living in and expects to be back within the next 2 weeks. Secondly, we've lined up a few friends for you. Philo Vance is going to drop in, and Ellery Queen is coming back. The rest of the creeps will remain the same. Now, it's getting early again. It's T4Y closing the doors of the Mystery Playhouse and saying goodnight. Sleep tight. This is the Armed Forces Radio Service.